There's a lot of buzz about Google NotebookLM. You can upload a document to NotebookLM and then it will create a AI podcast with two speakers to make that content that you've uploaded engaging and allow it to be something that could be a podcast. So this could be super useful for people who have a bunch of like docs, or, you know, they've done a PhD or a thesis or something maybe, and they've got all this content that they want to make more like digestible for people. Maybe that's a use case for it. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to explore it. I have not used it. This is going to be my first time ever using it. And I'm just going to give my real reaction as to how good of a job it does, especially because I am a podcast producer. That is my whole life here. I have a business called Bamby Media. We have 5 employees, 60 something clients that we produce podcasts for on a weekly basis. So I'm always looking at things that enter the market that are for podcasters or podcast adjacent. So let's get into this thing and see what it can do. Click on the Google NotebookLM so that you can find it. And then because I have a Google workspace, it gets me in there pretty quickly, like no big deal. Then I'm going to just click on new notebook and it's going to ask me to upload a source. Now I can just do that from my Google Drive, which is cool because I've got a bunch of Google Docs that I could choose from. What I might do is actually use an article that I've written for Medium that actually already is a podcast episode. It's just me though solo. I'm going to upload one of those articles and let's see what it does with that information. I'm going to use my podcast launch strategy article because that was a 30-minute-ish full deep dive YouTube video, as well as an article that we wrote which had like step-by-step information. So I'm going to use that one. It's giving me some information here. So audio overview, here we go. All right, so I'm going to go over to deep dive conversation, 2 hosts, English only. I'm going to go generate. Oh my God. All right, well, I'm going to see what that does. So it's saying it might take a few minutes. I'm going to come back when it has finished generating and I'm going to take a listen with you to see what it actually did. Okay, we're back. It took 3 minutes for it to generate this. So here it is over here. It's 9 minutes long. I'm scared to press play because I don't know what it's going to sound like, but let's give it a crack.
All right, so you ready to get that awesome podcast idea of yours out there?
Time to hit record and launch, right?
Well, hold on just a sec. Today's deep dive is all about making that launch legendary. And get this, we're doing it without blowing your budget on ads. We're going through 97 Podcast Launch Strategy.
By Bamby Media.
Yep, Bamby Media. And let me tell you, they've got some seriously smart stuff in here.
It's not just about hitting publish, you know? This guide's all about strategy.
Oh, absolutely.
Think about it like planning a surprise party. You wouldn't just spring it on your friend out of nowhere, right?
No way. Where's the fun in that?
Exactly. You build up the anticipation, get everyone excited for the big reveal.
Oh, my God.
That's where this whole pre-launch hype machine comes in.
Okay, so we're talking like 3 weeks before launch.
3 weeks out, yeah. And you might be thinking, time to shout it from the rooftops. But Bamby Media, they suggest a different approach.
Ooh, I'm intrigued. What do they recommend?
Holding back a bit. At least at first, instead of just dropping the podcast name right away, they suggest kind of teasing it out.
Teasing it out. I like it.
Right. Like, imagine posting,
some cryptic graph. What the actual hell is this? Wow. Okay, so I'm just trying to get my head around this. So we've got 2 people. The fact that they were, like, the interplay between the two of them where she's saying something, he's saying something, and he almost like he jumps in as well. Like, that's actually what happens in real conversation. The audio quality is, of course, on point. Like, it just sounds like they're right here in a studio with you because they're not actually in a studio. They don't actually exist. Wow. Okay, let me just keep going.
I don't know, some cryptic graphics on your LinkedIn or X.
You can definitely hear some of that robotic, like digital, though, in the actual audio. It doesn't sound proper. But if this was something that I didn't realize was AI, I don't know whether I would realize that it is AI, you know? Let's keep going.
Hints at the theme, but doesn't give it all away.
Oh, I love that. It's like a visual puzzle. Gets people guessing, sparking those conversations.
Oh my God. Even did a little stutter there. Gets people.
Gets people guessing.
Like, that's what a normal human. Oh my God. You guys, I don't know how to respond to this. My brain can't handle it. Wait, let's keep going.
You got it. It's all about that curiosity, that fear of missing out. Suddenly, you're not just passively scrolling, you're invested.
Okay, so we're building that pre-launch buzz, and then...
Well, this is where Bamby Media gets even more interesting. They're all about taking your audience behind the scenes. Give them a sneak peek.
Ooh, I like that. Like a little VIP access?
Exactly. Share little snippets from recording sessions. A
funny blooper reel, maybe.
Yeah, or even like a time lapse of your...
I tell you what, it makes Bamby Media sound like we really know what we're talking about. The fact that we have two people talking about the strategies that we have, wow, we're so famous right now. Like, we're celebrities because they are talking about our strategies. One thing I will say is that the title of the article is 97 Podcast Launch Strategy. And they said that at the beginning, that's just number 97, like episode 97. So if I was doing this for realsies, I obviously wouldn't have that bit in the front. I would make it that the title was something that made more sense when they led into it, like leading them into it. Okay, let's listen to a little bit more.
Podcast art coming together. It shows the human side of it all, you know?
It's huge. People connect with stories with that authenticity. It makes them feel like they're part of the journey from the very beginning.
And that feeling that they're in the loop, it's powerful. It builds community, loyalty, before your first episode even drops.
So smart. Okay, we've got the hype. We're giving sneak peeks. Say it's 2 weeks before launch now. What's next?
The big reveal. Time to unveil that masterpiece, the name, the logo, the whole shebang.
It's like the grand opening of a store. You want those eye-catching visuals that make people stop and think, I gotta check this out.
100%. A striking image.
Oh, what? This is really good. You guys, this is really good. Now, I'm listening to it from a perspective of, like, I'm not taking in all the information here. I'm just listening to it from a, how did they do? They are skipping bits that are in the article at this point. So there's not as much detail as the article gives. And there's also not as much detail as the whole YouTube, like, step-by-step guide that I did, where it was, you know, me in front of a whiteboard going, okay, this is step one, like, do, you know, really detailed stuff. They've condensed this down to 9 minutes and 21 seconds. So it's not probably going to hit everything. But I mean, I could imagine how this could be useful, especially if you have documents that you want to share maybe internally with your team. Like if you've got like a internal podcast, or you've got like a membership, or you've got a masterclass that you want to repurpose into something, and you've got an article for it, you've got like docs that are really heavy on information, or maybe you've got research notes that you've been putting together some sort of research that it's quite detailed, and then you upload all this and the AI like condenses it down into something that people could actually listen to and get the cliff notes of. That's probably what I like, how I'm interpreting it from my first listen through. It could be a companion piece though to the full-on article. The only thing I'd worry about is, yeah, like how accurate is it, and what information is it leaving out, and is that stuff that shouldn't be left out? There's, you know, more that I'd have to look at here, but the actual audio quality itself, like if we just listen to the dude, the man voice, just the depth of tone, like the big meatiness in the bass there.
Think about it. Would you rather read a restaurant menu or see a mouth-watering photo of the dish?
Photo every time.
Right.
So we're talking high-quality visuals, something that truly captures the essence of the podcast.
And this is all...
Yeah, so I think that it's doing a better job of the male voice than the female voice. The female voice is still... It's got inflections. It's those higher sort of frequencies. It's got a little bit more of that digital sound. Maybe it could probably still fool people. Maybe that it doesn't really matter, because it's something that you're just trying to condense down, make an article or something that's big into something smaller and more tolerable. So this is pretty bonkers. Like, This is hard for me to admit because I am a podcast producer. I'm a podcast producer, okay? I produce a lot of podcasts all the time. And this has done a really good job without anything, without anybody. It's not you, though. If the point is to build your personal brand, it's not your voice. You're not one of the hosts. That would be interesting if they could take your voice and then have you be one of the hosts and have you positioned as the one with the authority. That would blow even more of my mind. It's probably still a while off. Maybe not. I don't know. Maybe it's closer than we think. Oh, God. That could be interesting because it would save you potentially actually having conversations with anybody real. But do you want that? Like, in the same way, do you want that? Do you want to have not real conversations? What is that doing to podcasting as a whole? Isn't that the point of podcasting? Like, if I really think about that, the point of podcasting, not for every genre, but certainly for the ones that I feel are the ones I connect with the most, it's about having real conversations with people. You get their true feelings about something, or you're trying to dig into something. Look at shows like Joe Rogan and Diary of a CEO and Modern Wisdom. They're real conversations with very interesting people that go deeper than surface level, and you feel really connected to them. I don't see how you could replace that. I don't see how you could replace building a personal brand via this method. I don't think that's where the kicker is for this. I think that this would be super useful from a podcasting perspective. Let's say you wanted to have, like, you wrote an article daily, like daily news, you know, and you wanted that to be something that was shared almost like a radio breakfast show or something, where you've gone and found the news that you want to make sure people know about, and then you don't want to be the host, you just want two people to talk about it, you want to be the one that's researched it and found all that stuff, you put it up and then you have these two people talk about it. That would be actually a fine way to do that. You could have this as a branded internal show where you're distilling that information to people in your team, people in other teams, you're talking about updates, anything. You could really do it like that. If you're wanting to have two people in there to make it more engaging, then that's the way to do it. I have seen AI try before where it's, you know, you can feed in some information and then it creates a podcast episode, and that's always been solo, and that's been really bad. The AI has been not engaging because there's no inflection, there's no like intonation, there's no, like, the breaths are weird, just doesn't work. But it does work in this context for this AI model. I could listen to this and not be bored. That's really interesting to me. Would you fool people? Would you tell people? Would say, hey, by the way, this is AI. I mean, I guess you have to. That's probably part of the legal framework around the whole thing. Like, FYI, these aren't real people, but it's my real research. Like, it's my real notes. Just thinking about other use cases, like, you could maybe even, let's say you get an article or a bit of research that you're trying to distill, and it's not yours, it's somebody else's. You want to try and understand it more. You could feed it into this and then listen to it to maybe you learn better like that, listening to other people talk about it. Again, I don't know how accurate it is, like all these things. I don't know whether it would miss too much of the key facts, but that'd be worth trialing too, perhaps. I don't know. I'd love to know what you guys think. What possible use cases could you see for this notebook LM? Like, is there somewhere that you would really actually use this? What's the use case? It has blown my mind. It's actually baffling to me that we're now here in such a short space of time. Like, it's only been, I don't know, a year or so since everything really took off in the AI space. Upon second listen, I can definitely hear more of that, like, digital kind of doesn't feel quite real information, but that's just going to be getting better and better. So yeah, should I be worried, guys? Should I be worried? As a podcast producer, should I be worried? Am I just, you know, are we going to become obsolete soon? You don't even need us to produce your beautiful podcasts. You're just going to send it all to the robots and then be done with it? What do you think? Weigh in. Let me know. Have a good day.